Good morning, students. I welcome you all for this session on overview of module 5B, that is three-phase induction motor. So what are the things we are going to discuss today are introduction, advantages of three-phase induction motor, construction parts, principle of operation, and application. Starting with the introduction. So first we should know what is an electric motor. So an electric motor is a device which converts electrical energy into mechanical energy. So there are different types, or mainly there are two types of electric motor. One is the DC motor and another one is the AC motor. Again, advantages of three-phase induction motor, because under AC motor we have two types of motors. One is the single-phase AC motor and another one is three-phase induction motor. So what are the advantages of three-phase induction motor? So there are some reasons for using these three-phase induction motors. One is simple design and rugged construction, low price and easy maintenance. Operations are highly reliable, wide range of power ratings are available, and they can run essentially as a constant speed from no load to full load. So even though when the motor is runs, when the motor is made to run under full load also, it operates at a constant speed. And these motors are self-starting motors and they have very high efficiency and good regulation, speed regulation. Mainly, what are the construction parts? These induction motors have mainly two parts. One is the stator and the rotor. The stator is the stationary part of an induction motor. A three-phase winding is placed in the stator of the induction motor and three-phase supply is given to it. Next is the rotor. The rotor is the rotating part of an induction motor. So the rotor is connected to the mechanical load through the shaft. The construction of stator for both the kinds of three-phase induction motor remains the same. Next, again, these rotors are again classified. These alternator, these three-phase induction motors are also called as alternators. Again, the rotors of the alternators are of two types. The stationary part, the stator, and the rotating part is called as the rotor. We know this. And again, these rotors are further classified into two types. One is squirrel cage rotor and another one is slip ring or wound rotor or phase wound rotor. What is this squirrel cage rotor? This type of rotor has the simplest and cheap and most rugged type of construction. So this type of rotor consists of a cylindrical laminated core with the skewed slots. You can see these lines are called as skewed lines, where these conductors are placed under these skew lines. The rotor consists of uninsulated copper or aluminium bars. These are called as rotor conductors. These bars are placed in the slots. These bars are permanently short-circuited at each end with the help of the copper ring called end rings, because of which rotor resistance will be very less. So these end rings will be short circuited, and also this looks like the cage of a squirrel. So that is why the name squirrel cage rotor. The bars are usually braced to the end rings to provide good mechanical strength. Second one is the slip ring rotor or phase wound rotor. In this type of construction, rotor winding is similar to the stator. The rotor carries a three-phase star or delta connected distributed winding wound for same number of poles as that of the stator. The rotor core is laminated and slotted. The slots carry the rotor winding. The three-phase rotor windings are star connected internally and other end of the winding terminals are brought out. So this is the diagram for the slip ring rotor. So you can see additional resistance, external additional resistance can be added. You have the option for adding the additional resistance. Next, we'll know what is the principle of operation. So this induction motor works on the principle of electromagnetic induction. So when a three-phase supply is given to the three-phase stator winding, a rotating magnetic field is produced. The speed of this rotating magnetic field is called as the synchronous speed NS, which is represented in RPM. The rotating field produces an effect of rotating poles around the rotor. The direction of rotation of the rotating magnetic field is taken as clockwise direction. Next, what are the applications of induction motor? This induction motor is mostly used in industrial applications. The squirrel cage induction motors are used in residential as well as industrial applications, especially where the speed control of motor is not needed, in such cases, that is, these are used in submersible pumps, pressing machines, lathe machine, grinding machine, conveyor belts, flour mills, compressors, and other low mechanical power applications, these squirrel cage induction motors are used. Thank you.